The Honorable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'd like to ask the Premier some questions about mental health. The World Health Organization has urged and recommended that governments spend 10% of the global health budget on mental health and addictions in order to provide the services in mental health that a contemporary population needs. And yet, in Nova Scotia, we are a long way short of that at 6%, and we're also short of the Canadian average at 7%. So I want to ask the Premier, does he agree that we should be at least meeting, if not exceeding, these important kind of national and international benchmarks for the provision of services in mental health?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And we've made clear that mental health and addictions will be a priority for our government moving forward. We do have services out into communities, and we, like other jurisdictions, are struggling to find and to recruit psychiatrists, psychologists to our communities. But we're going to continue to our best. And we have a dedicated office now of mental health and addictions within the Department of Mental Health and within the Department of Health and Wellness. And we have dedicated resources. We'll be hiring an expert in this field to help us. And we're going to actually, even before that, increase our supports in this budget, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
The Nova Scotia College of Social Workers has recently pointed to the sharpness of the need in a report that explains that in Nova Scotia, people are, since the pandemic, experiencing higher levels of anxiety than people anywhere else in Canada. I'll table the part of the report that gives these numbers, but just to synopsize, 27% of the people in our province describe their anxiety level as high. That's a 20% jump from before the pandemic. And 16% of people in Nova Scotia report high levels of depression since the pandemic, and that's more than double the pre-pandemic number. And yet, today, we don't have in Nova Scotia any province-wide system for responding to mental health emergencies. So will the Premier let this House know what actual, concrete, real program improvements his government is going to be bringing forward that are going to make sure, particularly in this heightened time, that everybody has got access to the mental health programming they need?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And this pandemic has had impacts on families across this province and our country, Mr. Speaker. And I am concerned for Nova Scotians that face those invisible injuries and addictions are on the rise, Mr. Speaker. And that's why we'll be putting dedicated resources to fight this. And we're also looking at how we can bolster community supports, Mr. Speaker. We do have the toll-free line that Nova Scotians can call if there is a crisis, Mr. Speaker, and that is available 24/7. But yes, we will be putting more attention to this, and a fair government would. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party on his final supplementary.
Thank you. If a person today in Nova Scotia is dealing with a real burden of anxiety or depression, such that they need to see a mental health clinician promptly, the only way that they're able to accomplish that, if they haven't got benefits or insurance or the private means to pay out the often $200 or so an hour that private psychological services charge, the only way that they can do that, if they don't have that those means, those resources, is to turn to the private, the public system, where often in our community mental health system, the wait times are measured in the weeks and months. And so will the Premier admit that there is, in fact, a two-tiered mental health system today in operation in Nova Scotia?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And that's why we have invested $9.5 million into grant programs for communities to ensure that there is opportunities for Nova Scotians to seek the help that they need. We do have the crisis line, Mr. Speaker, and if those that are needing help immediately, those Nova Scotians are triaged to get that immediate help they need. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.